Home sweet home.
And the weather forecast.
Righty, Monday morning. It's all go. Full van here. Matty and Kieran. Good weekend, lad.
Yeah.
What did you get to?
Huh? Chill weekend.
Chill. Yeah. We've got a delivery here. All the blocks. Forklift. 2 foot-ins. Matty, good morning.
All right.
How
are you? All right, mate.
Yeah, fresh for the Monday.
Oh, feeling good, mate. Yeah,
ready to
rock and roll.
Right. So, I'll move move some pallets and that. That's the one I had on that other job. Righty. So yeah, two plots, one, two, identical, yeah? Profiles, looking good.
Oh, in the soup.
So we just started stacking. Obviously, don't interfere with the lines. Don't stack them out. Like I've put these pallets right where the lines are going, so we've got to move them now. This one's a 6-inch wall. Everything else is 4-inch cavity wall. Right, so just about to lay my first block now before 10 o'clock break. Basically what I've done is we strung the lines and I've just put a profile on the outside and then my dory like this, same on the other side. I'm going to run it. Matty's going that way and then that way, and I'm going to run that way. So we'll build three walls up together, yeah? Righty. Some of the stuff a bit stiffiest. We're in the soup. Right, Joe. Put a block in there, please. Joe. Monday morning rugby talk. What happened?
Lost.
So, what Joe was telling me this morning was that his team were up like nearly 20 points to nil when he came on, and then they lost when he came.
Fucker.
I'm only joking, mate. Right, that's rugby talk over. Oh, my team didn't play. They didn't play in the end, so we've got a good game coming next week. We've got to target that one. John Scudamore, it's called Dreams for Ross, or something it's called. Good mix up.
Scoo as in Scoo.
Anyway, I'll show you what I've got for lunch here. So, 10 o'clock. My drink's been in the fucking mud. A bit of berries, chicken, dark chocolate, and fruit. So, don't worry, I'll be making up with a pie for lunchtime. Alright, Matty. Some pies in here, have we?
Hey.
Have a look in here.
Oh, yeah.
So, what we've got here now, right, is. So, we've done one course with these profiles, and we're going to go on to the next course, and because of the amount of water, it's been raining quite a bit here, to be honest. I think the water's going down here. There's like a stream running behind there. So it's just like filling up. You can see the water. It's coming from the ground. You see it there, look. It's just filling up. So what happened was, once they put the block, the mortar on the block, the block's just went like that. So I said, take the mortar off. Drain a bit of the water and move, put the line down and move the block back, and just left it at one course. So I'm going down building corners. Put a corner over there. I'm going to build one here now. Yeah, keep them coming, Kieran. Shauna's on a mixer and cutting, and then the lads, we're just going to run one course inside and out everywhere. It's absolutely soaking wet here. It's muddy, it's wet.
Disgusting.
There.
Disgusting weather.
Disgusting. Are you complaining, Sean? Kieran's complaining here, so am I.
About the weather.
About the weather. What is it?
Doesn't affect
you. You're like amphibian or something.
Yeah,
right there, Kieran. And that, oh my god, get out, get out.
Fucking socks on, bastard.
I feel like it's all bloody day. Stop, start. Even when we thought the sun was coming out, it's raining. Go figure. So, yeah, I don't think we'll be here for much longer. Rightio. Last mix of the day, I reckon.
It's raining.
Hi, so Tuesday, I was meant to be on that other job Tuesday, but do you know what, just thinking about it, rather than splitting the gang up and then me going to hire another mixer, just go do that other job. So I'll just say yeah, yeah, just box the job off and then go over there with my mixer, Matty can go back on in the trenches. So what we've done this morning is, because I know the bond of that house there, and Matty, we built the corners yesterday. So Matty's just going to run in, and then I'm just going to go on this spot here and build the corners. Because I know the bond, we're copying that basically. So I'm just going to build corners on this house, and then we can just have a day tomorrow running everything in, and then we'll be done and dusted. What happened? What just happened?
Oh,
was that Kieran?
No, it's
Hello. Right, it's 7:15. I'm ready for lunch. 1, 2, 3, 4 and a half, really. Corners inside and out. So after lunch I'll finish this one, finish that one, and then I'll start getting the train going, the block laying train. Oh, you're hard. Righty, so I don't know if this is interesting or not, but what I'm doing is I'm building corners here, right? And in between building corners, I'm having the lads to put a coarser block on dry, put a string line and put mortar. So what I'll do then, in between this, I'll jump onto this, run them in, dead easy, and then I'll go back onto the corner and the lads will put blocks on top of these, yeah, and then I'll do the inside. That way I'm constantly laying. Look, Kieran's setting that one out there, so that'll be good going. Pretty much the whole house, corners inside and out, and of course through. And I've only one trowel, basically, just me. So, yeah.
That's it, dude.
Absolutely shattered. And you, Matty?
I'm alright, mate. You do one paper job, man.
Iron? Don't fucking lie. Hey, I have to say, my missus, right, is carrying me at home. I did a 4:30 feed this morning for the baby, yeah?
You saw it now, yeah?
Yeah, mate.
I'm gonna go, mate.
Yeah, see you tomorrow. Right. There you go. One course to get us out of the soup. Because he launched them in the end there. Right. You know what they say, don't you? A clean cavity is a happy whining. Only reason I'm saying that is because we were working on a job before for about 5 years for Anvil Homes, and the contracts manager was the bee's knees. Steve Wyman, if he's listening or watching, shout out to the GOAT contracts manager, best contracts manager of all time. He would know everything about every single trade. Everything had to be spot on all the time, every trade. No. Yeah, so basically what we were saying was a clean cavity is a happy wyman. You just come around and check everything. Not like the contracts managers these days, which, fuck, I'm not saying too much, but they're nowhere near as good as this guy. And he was running multiple jobs, which were like, God, I don't know, must have been like, at one time, he's probably managing about 1,000 houses, honestly, and he knows everything. Anyway, see you later. So, what's happened is, this morning I haven't done any recording because we've been smashing it. So we've pretty much gone round that house. Generator's died, so the client has gone to the tool hire shop to get another one. Plus the pump he's got is, it's not touching this really because it's filling up the water. So we thought we'd use this time to put these wind posts in. So what I've done here, got a drawing, so I've set out, basically there's a pillar here, you see there's a window there.
Excuse me, just push that one more time.
And then there's a bifold door there with a pillar, so I've measured it so the blockwork comes to here and the blockwork comes to there. So I don't want this wind post to clash with the lintel, because on another job we had someone else put the lintel posts in, and then it was not enough bearing on the lintel, it clashed to the lintel. So just show you what we're doing. So we're going to lift this one in now, yeah, and drill it.
Yeah.
Yes, we've got all the gear here. All the gear and the idea. Right, let's go. Thanks for helping. Yeah. Just shimmy it like that. Oh, what are you doing? Right. Okay. Yeah. Oh, there's okay, yeah. Yeah. Okay, just get your level. Where's the level?
put it flush on top of it there. It's not bad, is it?
No, it's good.
Okay, how is it for... Okay, drill that now. Go on, Joseph. Get in there, lads.
That way, so...
Put it on the hammer setting. Come on now.
Middle.
Hammer drill.
There you go.
Just straight down you gotta go.
Right.
I think that's enough recording. We'll go and set out the other one. So, there was... just seeing which way it's leaning. So it wants to come this way and this way. So obviously I tightened the lowest one first before packing. So, does that need two packers to come this way?
Use the dirty level. It's not perfect, but it's, I mean, it's all right, you know what I mean? I mean, yeah, it's good enough.
Fuck, what happened here, lad? How's the mixer? Did that all the way over here? So, the mixer's gone over the mixer, over the wheelbarrow,
yeah,
and then stayed on and rolled down the hill.
Yeah.
Because it was still on. Is that the bucket? What? Oh, bucket's fucking good. Yeah. Is the plug alright, yeah?
Yeah.
You switched it off, yeah?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, gosh.
This shit is
on. Oh. Oh. People in the window there looking at you there, Sean.
What's the thing with the mist? It was like wobbling.
Oh. Yeah. It wasn't the wind, because the wind's going the other way.
Yeah.
Anyway, bit of entertainment for the... Oh, oh, Sean, I love you, mate. I am absolutely cream crackered. I'll go up here now and show you. So we've had two deliveries of blocks in 2 days, 13 pack on a wagon, so 26 packs. We got one full one, and say probably say two packs left. Okay, so we've gone through 24 packs of blocks in 3 days. Sound? I'll speak to you tomorrow.
Yeah,
well, try
matey.
Yeah. So wind posts are in, all the perimeters are done. This one's up to height. There is a split block to go on the internal before the block and beam. Matty's going to come back on Friday. The delivery's coming on Friday morning for the split, so there's no point coming here tomorrow. There's not a day's work here. There will be with a split, so Matty's going to come back on Friday. Finish this internal course of split, so basically it's a 100mm piece all the way around, and then there's a common on some of the walls. And that wall, internals need doing on that one, so 2 courses 6 inch and 4 courses 4 inch. Yeah, I mean that's flipping good going considering the slop we've been working in. Right, see you all tomorrow. Hi, so I'm up here and I'm just going over with Joe now what the crack is. So first job we're going to do, we're going to take all these handrails off and just basically hammer off. So we'll take them ones off and we'll take these ones because there's one coarser block to go inside and out again. So insulation, they haven't got any wall plate here, wall plate's going straight on there apparently. Told him to sort this out. I'm just going to, hi, okay, so I've been to the dentist to get a new tooth thing, filling, not a filling, but basically my, I had a KFC, bit of my tooth came out, sorted now. Anyway, come back and in a nutshell, yeah, the battery died earlier. Oh, look, this one here. So we've got this steel here now, right, and it's not your bog standard steel. Wanted. Hey, yeah, 5 stars. Now, thanks to stars to go to a car. How many stars do you have to get on GTA for a helicopter to go after you? 4? 5 for army, is it? 6 for army?
Army
trucks. Yeah, you get army.
3 stars.
Yeah, okay. Anyway, these here, right? So if I put a damp tray, I always put a damp tray on the lintel, all the time, okay? Now if I did that now, I'm gonna have, like, it's not enough gonna work, is it? So I'm gonna have to cut the damp tray, and what's the point of having a damp tray with bloody holes in it? So I think, yeah, but if the damp tray's not on this course, I mean, what's stopping the water going in there and down off the end? So I don't know whether I just put from here. Are there holes in here? Look, yeah. So what I'm going to do, right, is run a course inside and out and put a damp tray. And it's getting rendered with key rend or whatever it is. So pickled me that one. Otherwise, I'd have to put 3 every one. I'm not doing that to turnips every one. I'm not doing that. I'm on bloody, just my a millionth visit for peanuts as it is. So no way, no way. It's not part of the bloody deal, this. So I'll run a damp course on the next course. Yeah, I think that's the way to do it. Really, that's the way to do it. Just not my usual cup of tea, do you know what I mean? So righty, get them in. Oh yeah, and then on these I've asked Joe to dry bond and then slit the back of the block with this cutter, so yeah, we can run one course through basically for the bond. Righty, I'll show you the what's been happening here. Oh, the amount of basically, look, cutting the block, back of the block like this, there's some cuts there that are just, you know, he's loving it. Look at this one here, he's done. Look at that, look at that. Look at that, you never know there's a bit of steel behind it. But the insulation, I've had to cut it down because it doesn't quite work to 450, the sheet of insulation. This is a kind of stuff you've got to deal with. People say, oh, how much do you want to do that for? Square meter rate? Yeah, yeah, okay. It's not that, mate. You know, this is the sort of crap you've got to deal with. Cavity trays. Trying to bloody jungle book around scaffolding. Carrying blocks from down the bottom there, no forklift. In a really highly exposed area. No problem for us, right? We've got a bit of a tricky one here where we've got this roof coming down. We've got this big window here, porch, and basically this wall can be as wet as it wants because it's an external skin, yeah? Above the roof can be as wet as it wants, but down below can't. So, how are we going to do this? We're going to need a vertical damp. What we've done here is just put a profile in here, ties, and just bang the wall in. Because I couldn't be asked, not as if I couldn't be asked, but didn't have the luxury of Joe being here all day to fiddle about here. Just need to get the wall up. So what we're going to do here now is we're going to fill these up, and because I didn't know exactly what I was doing, because this pattern wasn't here for me to get the pad stones on for the steel, I just toothed it, and you know, from there I could have done whatever. So now that I'm at the stage, we're going to fill these up with halves, yeah, here. We're going to have a vertical 4-inch stamp down here, tucking into the external of the lintel, so anything that hits here hits the vertical damp and stays outside. Then this inside, I told Joe to just infill here all the way up to here, and then what we're going to do is we're going to bring a cavity tray 175, we're going to wrap it round with these preformed ones. It's not the perfect preformed corner one, but I'll manage to do something, or I can actually make it out of 600 damp and fold it and tape it up properly. We got any on that double-sided tape in the van? I think we have on the shelf, yeah? Yeah, so it's all good. I'll give you another video once it's done, yeah? Lunch updates. We got a chicken teeth here. Chocolate glaze, and what I'll do for extra protein is put the chicken in with this one, because you don't have to get enough here. And then keep rolling. Well, I think I'm it. What were you singing? No, are you singing something else? No. Rolling over lintel. Bloody aeroplanes all day over here. Right, because of the wind picking up a bit here now, the name of the game is to get up to that steel. So if I build like a triangle up here to that on a single skin, I can guarantee you it'll be out of plumb or blown down. I'll put my life savings on it if I've got any. And so what I'm going to do is build maybe two, or one, and one, and one, and one, and one. Sean, I'm going to need more blocks on here, please, mate. And not only have I got a radio going or music player, because the wind's picking up and all these scaffold tubes now, it's like some sort of orchestra. Wind orchestra, you see it? Put your finger on that and it does da-da-da-da. Hear it? And then certain directions you get a different noise. Bit of a remix. Oh, God. Hiya. I've been in this morning to get a bit of my tooth put back or something like that. Basically it's come out again. So I think I've...
What's your name, please?
Vaughan Francis. Yeah. It's I think I've swallowed the thing. It's alright to it's not gonna like cause damage. No, alright.
Let me just double check what the material is. I mean none of the materials we use, of
course. Yeah, it's fine. Yeah. Alright then.
And it'll just come out the other end, so you won't want
to. Oh yeah, alright.
Okay.
Cheers. Right. Three on the inside, four on the outside, and starting to get a bit wobbly. So, for any chance of getting up there, which I don't really think I will, what I'm going to do is, what I like to do is build the internal skin with the ties as much as I can, and then the next day, because the ties have gone off, clad it with insulation, and then put my outside skin, because what happens is if you do two skins on the same day, you tie, when you're knocking the insulation, it just shuffles about in the mortar and gets loose. And when you're building like a gable end, you don't want any loose ties. Any loose ties, huh? So anyway, what I'm doing here, so I know that it's gonna be perfect, is then the bed, insulation, and then I'm just gonna put the ties like really close. Can I have more ties, please, Sean? I'm just gonna double up on the ties, just to give it extra strength. So, you know, there's four ties there at 1200. Less really. So, when I put my block on there, I'm gonna do one and one now. Otherwise, you know, it'll be out of plumb and all that. So, yeah, Sean's happy. Sean! Smile, will you? He's happy the mix is clean and it's not even four. So basically he'd put this wall plate in for us, yeah, and he's like suspended it there. It's like quite solid except for this scaffold bloody wobbly in it. He's used one of the wall plates that we needed up there to brace it, but I'm not going to complain. It's in. We're gonna have to get more wall plate, but we've put in blocks and brick, and we just kind of put them in like this. I'm gonna fill it in, and we're ready to do the damp, aren't we, Joseph? Yeah. So that half needs to come out, and then if you put that 100mm piece there, basically enough to put, I think, the first. That's about 175 there. So obviously there's lead gonna go along here, and then it'll come back, and I'll probably do one there, and then I'll put another tray up there, so it's a double tray, maybe double tray. Alright, that's the update. Oh yeah, we asked for Feb, and this is what we've had. And because Sean's never used this stuff before, he's put in one bottle cap. Put in one bottle cap per mix, but with this stuff it's dog shit, to be honest with you. So what we've had to do is just, because you only need about 5 mil, is that millilitres, yeah, on the other stuff per mix, or 10 millilitres. So with this stuff you just kind of that, yeah, so you a couple of dollops in the mix and you're alright. So There's mortar we've been having off him with this stuff, because he's been gauging it wrong, is like basically laying bricks with sand from the beach. So that should get your gruel, get your slop. As you can tell, I've lost complete motivation for the afternoon, so camera's out and I'm pissing about, and basically I'm going to show you what's inside my toolbox. That is a toolbox, the sign of neglect. It's my you know, milk crates are banned off site, but somehow toolboxes aren't, so that's a stand on that to get a little bit higher. But because we've been rushing from job to job recently, I've just been kind of put my tools in the buckets. Bloody hell, another hole there. Oh, what is going on with these tools? So showing inside the toolbox is probably like someone coming to your house and looking at, inside your drawer next to your bed, probably. Is that true? Ah, here we go. Be warned. Neglect. Right, so with the rain, it's been copped a bit of a few puddles in here. Got a wet glove. Everything's rusty. Everything is rusty. Sun cream for when, you know, the sun's out. Wrong time of year for that. Some battered lines. Staple gun. My cheapies, Sturmat specials. Shout out. Oh my gosh. Ugh, Abby, drawings of all. Biddy putter is this like? More gone all mouldy, look. Ugh. What a dirty bitch. Some paintbrushes for cleaning my toolbox again. This is what I'm looking for. This bad boy here to push the mortar in. That is all. So, Joe, shall we have a look inside your toolbox?
Next episode.
Next episode. Alright, you're fine. Yeah. Yeah, so you can have a chance to get your little butt plugs out. Oh my god, the scaffold's horrible. So, they're equal sizes, little end of the day competition. They're shot put, block put. Who's going first? Yeah. Me first.
It's got runner.
First time. Left here. Ah, two hand. Ooh. It's really windy up here. I thought the wall would be down today after last night's wind, but it's not. It's just a little bit moved, but it's fine. As you can see here, I've put another three courses on it. Just a little bit moved in the middle there. So put three courses on it, it's ready for padstone. I'm not chancing putting a padstone on. I'm going to bed these wall plates. And I got two padstones put in there. Sean's going to cut them now. My height. Right, Hi, so we come over to this job again in Charlotte Bay. So that one over there, we're just on now. Too windy to put the final pad stones on. I swear to God, that job has tested me. I didn't want to... I start a job, smash it, finish it, next. Hate having to leave something half done unless I know it's gonna be. So with that one over there, I'm pulling my hair out. My blonde, beautiful hair. Anyway, back on this one now. So I'm nearly done, 95. They're having the bill now anyway. I'm giving them the bill. So on this one here, so in a nutshell, joiner's been, the roof is on site, and the windows and doors are all here. I'll show you them in a minute. But the client has realised that the internal measurement here is like 570, and he's got worktop here, and he doesn't want his worktop sticking out. So what he said is that he wants to bring the he spotted this before ordering the bifolds, so he's ordered the bifolds and made them 100mm shorter, meaning I got to bring my block work out an extra 100mm. He's going to put 4x2 on this two skins or layers, but I need to basically with two the block work, we're going to bring it in out an extra 100mm. So that was something that, you know, wasn't picked up, so we're back to do that. And there's like, because he's having what they call them, open eaves or something like that, so Joe's just filling in a little bit of bricks on either side so the plaster can go right in between the spars, trusses, whatever you want to call it. That's pretty much it really. I think he wants us to go around patching, because they've hacked the whole house and there's big holes here and there, so like little things like this just wants patching up. So a bit of a cushy afternoon really for the lads. I gotta go back and get my tooth sorted, so I don't know, I think I'm about gonna get a gold grill in the bottom, get a big chain, maybe a tattoo on the face. A gold grill would be cool.
I've got a stunning bar. I mentioned the past like a running joke.
Hiya mate. I've just been thinking, you know, whilst I'm building this here now, so it's got a little brick to put in there, yeah? Now, you know these wall plate straps? Well, they're not on yet, but anyway, if you cut the 90 degree off, yeah, and if you drill a strap, yeah, one or two, yeah? Long one if you can, like an 1800 one, yeah, from there you can drill that down here onto this block work. Hopefully the plaster can lose it somewhere, and on the inside do that one, drill into the steel and drill into here, but don't do it too soon, let it go off for at least a week before you start drilling here, please. Yeah, just thinking, you know, I give it extra strength. Right, yeah, these are the doors and all that. Joe, he wants to make this smaller now because they've changed the way the stairs are going. There's like a wall partition or something here, so he's changed that. So he wants this now to be coming to 4.2, which is, you know, somewhere there. So we have to tooth this out and bring this, so again another little extra bit of day work here for us. So we're not going to be working tomorrow, Saturday. Joe's going to be starting for the first team tomorrow, bit of a promotion again. Seanus is having a... Hey, are you going in tomorrow, yeah?
Yeah.
Yeah? You know the crack there, don't you? Mm-hmm. Okay, so he's going to start the job putting the cavity socks in and cleaning up. I'm going to play rugby tomorrow after a few weeks off, and hope everyone enjoys the weekend. Adios, amigos.